YouTube is sending you the Zoom link. Somehow I have made all the important things on dictionaries, encyclopedias, thesauruses. Ready for Zoom link? Zoomers are all waiting. Hurry up. Good evening. Guys, open your chat box. Oh, which material, Pradeep? People will do all that. Because we are making so much material. I am creating the monster. I am Victor Frankenstein and I am creating the monster that will destroy me. People will sell my material. They will make money out of it. It is a criminal offense. What can I do? I will go to the police and try to stop them. I am not getting time to go to the police because I am spending day and night making new material to help students. And those students are so busy, they are selling my material, they don't have time to study. I'm not well, I need a surgery, I need to rest. But nothing is going to stop me. I am going to help all of you. I am going to make material. Oh yeah, they asked about dictionaries and encyclopedia last time. And I found out that it is because in literary terms books, it is there. All the literary terms books, if you collect and study, you will get all this. Doesn't matter. You just listen to me. I am excited about dictionaries and encyclopedias. Now, shall we start? Are you all here? How many people are there in Zoom? On YouTube, everybody has come? I'm going to start. I'm going to give PDF also so that you can sell it. I must be really stupid, na? Making so much material, giving it in groups. People won't join my courses. They will only sell my material and live out of it. Doesn't matter. No problem. We are all serving our muse. No problem. I have no problem. Dictionaries and encyclopedias. Which of these is true? All the earliest modern dictionaries in European languages. Were compiled in the 17th century. Do you think that is true? You think that is true? Let us see what you think. A forerunner of Johnson's dictionary was Nathan Bailey's dictionary, published in 1721. In 1721, do you think dictionaries were there? Johnson's dictionary had a very fine preface. That is true, I think. The work on the largest and most comprehensive German language dictionary was started by Brothers Grimm. They made fairy tale collection. You think they started dictionary? One or two of these is wrong for sure. Tell me which of these is wrong. Everybody is not bad. Correct. 99% of people are good. Only 1% is not bad. They are, because of their limitations, they are doing things like that. But they will also be transformed, I'm sure. 99.9% people are good, I think. Hello, Cherry. Hello, Abdur. Everybody. Hello. ABCD, bolo. Kaun sa hai true, kaun sa hai false. These Zoomers will never understand me. I should make one book on myself to saying, please understand that when I give four important top points in the slide, most of the time, all of it will be true because I don't want you to read wrong sentences and get confused. Of course. Which of these is true? You think I will kill myself and make wrong sentences? Never. I will try to make it as correct as possible. Cha-ching! Obviously, all are correct. All the earliest, modern, they go, answer, all are true. Will you trust me? Now, listen, all the earliest modern dictionaries of European languages were compiled in the 17th century. Who said? I did not find out. Cadden said. Cadden said. M.A.R. Habib and Cadden. Cadden said all the earliest modern dictionaries in European languages were compiled in the 17th century, remember. A forerunner of Johnson's dictionary was Nathan Bailey's dictionary from 1721. Johnson's dictionary had a fine preface, correct? The work on the largest and most comprehensive German language dictionary was started by Brothers Grimm. Abhi to yaad rahega na? Now you won't forget na? Remember, all the major dictionaries came in 17th century. 100 years later, Johnson published his dictionary with a preface. Johnson's dictionaries ke pehle bhi ek dictionary tha. Nathan Bailey's dictionary, 1721. And the work on the biggest German dictionary was started by Brothers Grimm. Will you remember? Remember, everyone? Ta-dang! 4 points you got regarding dictionary. Brothers Grimm, who compiled fairy tales, also made German language dictionary. Johnson's dictionary. Before that, there was Nathan Bailey's dictionary. And all the major dictionaries of European languages started in the 17th century. Did you get that, everyone? Clear, everyone? By the end of 1 hour, you should remember all these things. Okay, next. New English Dictionary on Historical Principles. The New English Dictionary on Historical Principles, 1884, was later called what? New English Dictionary on Historical Principles, 1884, and it went on till 1928. Don't forget, very, very important. On Historical Principles. Shh, quiet. It went on till 1928. It was later called what? Is it Oxford English Dictionary? Yeah. Is it Webster's Dictionary? Yeah, is it Cambridge Dictionary? Or is it Fowler's Dictionary? YouTubers, tell me, because Zoomers are saying, some YouTubers went wrong. It is Oxford English Dictionary. So no, Oxford English Dictionary was first called New English Dictionary on Historical Principles. Don't forget, Oxford English Dictionary, first called New English Dictionary on Historical Principles, 1884 to 1928, it was published. Oxford English Dictionary was one of the oldest and biggest good dictionaries, modern dictionaries. It was based on historical principles, okay? New English Dictionary, huh? Webster is American, correct? Webster is American. So New English Dictionary is on historical principles is Oxford English Dictionary. Clear, everyone? I'm repeating and saying so that you won't forget. New English Dictionary on historical principles, 1884 to 98. Oxford Dictionary, later it was called. Don't forget. Ta-da-dang! Next point, next question. Who of the following was not an editor of New English Dictionary on Historical Principles? Who of the following was not an editor of the New English Dictionary on Historical Principles? What is your comment? Because of constantly sitting in light, my eyes are not good at all and I can't read properly. Yeah, I read now. I also talked about it. What is it? What is your comment? Thank you so much for wonderful revision of Maharashtra set. Okay, thank you. Is that what you mean? Thank you very much. No, all of them are not editors. One is wrong. One is obviously wrong. Yes, that is Fowler. Fowler made another dictionary later. Fowler is wrong. Others are correct. Fowler's dictionary is different. You know that, na? This is New English Dictionary of Historical Principles, 19th century. James Murray, Henry Bradley, Sir William Craig. Sit nahi. Sit or stand nahi, sir. Sir William Craig, Dr. C.T. Onions. Remember, Murray, Bradley, Craig and Onions. They are the editors of New English Dictionary on Historical Principles. Fowler nahi hai. Remember? Will you remember now? Murray, Bradley, Craig, Onions. Craigy Onions. Roger Fowler nahi hai. अरे एमएस सेट में बहुत सारे अच्छे अच्छे क्वेश्चंस थे सिंपल सिंपल वाले. यू विल पास स्टिल, डोंट वरी. रॉजर फाउलर इट वाज नॉट देयर. एक्चुअली रॉजर फाउलर वाज अ लिंग्विस्ट. अनदर फाउलर इज देयर. आई विल कम अक्रॉस, वी विल कम टू दैट. ओके, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. इन विच ईयर डिड वेबस्टर्स अमेरिकन डिक्शनरी, रिमेंबर अमेरिकन वेबस्टर. मुझे अच्छा नहीं लगता स्पेक्स. माय ग्लैमर इज विल बी अफेक्टेड, दैट इज व्हाई. हाँ, मैक्सिमम क्वेश्चंस केम फ्रॉम एनसाइक्लोपीडिया. सुचित्रा शिंदे, यू हैव टू स्टडी एनसाइक्लोपीडिया थरली. सो मेनी पीपल सेड दे गॉट सो लॉट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम एनसाइक्लोपीडिया. हाँ सुनो, वेबस्टर्स अमेरिकन डिक्शनरी फर्स्ट केम इन विच ईयर. अरे 1778 तो नहीं होगा. इट वॉज सो अर्ली ना. 1778 में कुछ नहीं होगा. 1778 इज टू अर्ली. 1998 हो ही नहीं सकता. 1928 इज टू लेट. सो इट मस्ट बी 1828. आई डिलिबरेटली गेव लाइक दैट सो दैट यू विल गेस लाइक दिस. टरांग 1828. सो नो 1728 इज लाइक टू अर्ली. Webster's came after this. No, before this, before this. Webster's came first, then came New English Dictionary on Historical Principles. Dekho, Webster's Dictionary of the English language is American. Remember that. 1728 is too early. 1998 hoi nahi sakta. Too late. 1928 or 1828. You go for 1828. Webster's American Dictionary made in 1828. Will you remember? Don't forget, okay? Thank you. Bindi nahi lagai. Because I didn't get up from my seat. I was teaching An Academy Special Literary Terms. I hope all of you attended. An Academy Special free hai. Or for the past 1 hour, I didn't get up from my seat. I was making this PowerPoint. I made this in one hour. 1 hour hi mila mujhe. The compendious dictionary of the English language was an earlier form of Dash. The compendious dictionary of English language, 1806, I think. Compendious Dictionary of the English Language came just before another thing came. The Compendious Dictionary of the English Language came in 1806. Dikhati hun. You know, the Compendious Dictionary of the English Language came in 1806 just before something else came. So now you answer me. All of you should answer. 1828, Webster's dictionary came. Compendious dictionary of the English language came just before Webster's. And it is an earlier form of Webster's. Fowler's ke baare mein maine kuch nahi bola, Sabir. Why are you talking about Fowler's now? Webster's dictionary, listen everybody. Webster's dictionary came in 1828. Just before that, he made another version, Webster made. That is called Compendious Dictionary of the English Language, 1806. 1806 dictionary called Compendious Dictionary is an earlier form of Webster's dictionary. Yaad rahega abhi? Will you remember? Webster's dictionary came in 1828. Compendious Dictionary of the English Language, 1806, was an early... OED means Oxford English Dictionary. That is the world famous short form, OED. Oxford English Dictionary. You know, in NET, they are checking whether you have general knowledge reading. General knowledge is very important. Reading about books, about everything, about news. OED, world famous short form. Remember that, okay? OED means Oxford English Dictionary. Clear? 1828, Webster's Dictionary. Just before that came Compendious Dictionary of the English Language by Webster. Everybody clear? Zoom link. Okay, I'll show next question. A dictionary of modern usage. A dictionary of modern usage. Wow. All these dictionaries you should have in your house. This dictionary of modern usage, do you have in your house? It was the most famous dictionary made by whom? Dictionary of modern usage is a famous dictionary made by Henry Watson Fowler. Fowler's Dictionary of Modern Usage. That is what it is called. Fowler's Dictionary of Modern Usage. That is 1926. 1926. Will you remember? Fowler's Dictionary of Modern Usage. 1926. Henry Watson Fowler. Then, who edited A History of American English on Historical Principles? Who edited A History of American English on Historical Principles? Remember, in American English, based on historical principles, one man alone sat and made the dictionary. Wow, what a wonderful work it will be. I'm not giving any clue. I'm just saying, one man made history of American English on historical principles. One man sat and made. Yeah, now tell me everybody correctly, only you tell me. One man sat and made, crying because he was onions. So many onions were there. He was crying. History of American English on Historical Principles, made by onions. Will you remember? Onions only. Crying and making History of American English on Historical Principles. That onions was there where? That onions was there in that this group also. New English Dictionary on Historical Principles. Aray, ye title copy paste kar raha hai. Ek dictionary ka naam New English Dictionary on Historical Principles. Theek hai, onions bhi tha usme. और अनियंस गया अमेरिका वहां बैठ के रो रो के बनाया अ हिस्ट्री ऑफ अमेरिकन इंग्लिश ऑन हिस्टोरिकल प्रिंसिपल्स. कुछ नया टाइटल नहीं डाल सकता था वो. क्या है अनियंस क्राइंग एंड मेकिंग अ हिस्ट्री ऑफ अमेरिकन इंग्लिश ऑन हिस्टोरिकल प्रिंसिपल्स. उससे पहले ऑक्सफर्ड यूनिवर्सिटी ऑक्सफर्ड इंग्लिश डिक्शनरी का पहला फॉर्म वो भी बनाया, एन इंग्लिश डिक्शनरी. विल यू रिमेंबर नाउ? Next. एडमिट कार्ड गलत है क्या? इतना बड़ाई में वेट 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 आई थिंक आंसर इज रॉन्ग वेट आई आई रिमेम्बर इट इज अनियंस वेट 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 आंसर इज रॉन्ग आई थिंक लेट मी फाइंड आउट हिस्ट्री ऑफ अमेरिकन इंग्लिश और यू विल किल मी भगवान प्लीज इट शुड बी अनियंस I just made 1 hour ago and dictionary of history of American English on historical principles. Take rain. It is in this book. I will check it. Check this book only. Don't kill me. Now don't kill me. Where are my specs? I can't see anything. Did I make a mistake? Don't kill me. Okay, wait. I am finding out whether it is onions. हिस्ट्री अनियंस ने लिखा लेकिन ये था अनियंस का ऑक्सफोर्ड डिक्शनरी ऑफ इंग्लिश एटिमोलॉजी था अनियंस रो रो के अमेरिका नहीं गया अनियंस रो रो के एटिमोलॉजी डिक्शनरी लिखा आई लाइक इट अनियंस रो रो के एटिमोलॉजी डिक्शनरी लिखा उसी समय अमेरिका में कौन गया क्रेग और ह्यूलबर्ट वो दोनों जाके अमेरिकन इंग्लिश ऑन हिस्टोरिकल प्रिंसिपल ये लोग चुराए टाइटल अनियंस एटिमोलॉजी लिखा रो रो के फॉरगेट अमेरिका ओके अमेरिका में कौन गया ये क्रेग गया ये भी था वहां वो दूसरा डिक्शनरी था ना ओईडी से पहले आया था ओईडी के पहले ओईडी के पहले आया था न्यू इंग्लिश डिक्शनरी उसका एडिटर था विलियम क्रेग दे बीट अनियन वो लोग अनियन को बोला यहां बैठ के एटिमोलॉजी डिक्शनरी बना लो हम जा रहे हैं अमेरिका Now, I will explain in English for those who don't know English. Onion is innocent. I will explain once again for those who don't know English. The New English Dictionary on Historical Principles. New English Dictionary. That was the original form of OED or Oxford English Dictionary. Murray, Bradley, Craig, Onions, all were editors. Onions said, okay, I will make one more dictionary. Craig said, Onions, you sit here and make etymology dictionary. Onion ro ro ke etymology dictionary banaya. Kyunki onions hai ro ro ke etymology dictionary banaya. Then Onions sat and made etymology dictionary, crying. He made etymology dictionary because he's Onions, he's crying. And making etymology dictionary is so difficult. At that time, this man, Craig, dekho Craig, Craig, took one more guy, Hulbert, and went to America. They made a dictionary there. But remember, they stole the title. From New English Dictionary, another title, they didn't make. Two dictionaries, same title. History of American English on Historical Principles. That is also same title. Historical Principles, dono. Abhi to theek bol rahi hu. Now I am saying correctly. I am making a lot of mistakes because it is a teaching technique and also because I'm not sleeping, I'm going crazy making PPT. After your exam, I will sleep, okay? All right. Ayyo, will you remember now? Onions made what dictionary? Etymology dictionary, Oxford Dictionary of English Etymology. 1966 only. He lived a long life. Onions made etymology dictionary in 1966 only. He began in 19th century. Bahut buddha hua hoga tab tak 1966. Will you remember? Only in our YouTube channel I can show all these things. Oxford Dictionary of English Etymology, C.T. Onions. Will you remember? Oxford Dictionary of English Etymology, Onions, 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 Onions. American Dictionary of Historical Principles, Craig and Hulbert. English Dictionary of Historical Principles, so many people. Murray, Onions, Craig. Then one more man was there. Who was that? Who was that? Let me go and see. Bradley. Murray, Bradley, Craig, and Onions. Now you will remember, na? Okay, Onion story over. Now we are moving on to other things. Onions is over. Now we'll play other games. Which of these did Ebenezer Brewer? I think Brewster. Wait. Which of these is Ebenezer Brewer? Brewer's Dictionary of 1870. Everything is gone. My body, my eyes, my part by part, everything is going because of your exam. Ha, Brewer, correct. Ebenezer Brewer made which dictionary in 1870? Idioms, Dictionary of Idioms and Phrases. Dictionary of Phrase and Fable. Dictionary of Phrasal Verbs. Dictionary of Phrase and Fable. Fables bhi nahi hai. Main toh kabhi nahi likhungi. Dictionary of Phrase and Fable. ऐसा नहीं लिखूंगी मैं ग्रामेटिकली करेक्ट ही लिखूंगी. अरे सुनो, जो मैं बोल रही हूं सुनो ना. अगर मैं बना रही हूं ऑप्शन तो आई विल नेवर राइट फ्रेज एंड फेबल. आई विल ओनली राइट करेक्टली. ये ब्रूअर ने लिखा डिक्शनरी ऑफ फ्रेज एंड फेबल. व्हाट कैन आई डू. ए एंड सी आई मेड. Did you understand what I'm saying? Ebenezer Brewer in 1870 wrote Dictionary of Phrase and Fable. Dictionary of Phrase and Fable. These two other options I made. Dictionary of Idioms and Phrases and Dictionary of Phrasal Verbs I made. Ebenezer Brewer is brewing some coffee. Some drink he is brewing. And writing phrases and fable. Because he is more interested in the drink he is brewing, probably. That is why he forgot to put one S. Phrase and fable. Dictionary of Phrase and Fable was made by Ebenezer Brewer while he was brewing coffee. Ha ha, main send karungi na telegram mein. Kuch hai main jo send nahi karti. सब कुछ सेंड करती हूं ना. डिक्शनरी ऑफ फ्रेज एंड फेबल. ग्रामेटिकली रॉन्ग टाइटल बिकॉज ही वॉज एंगेज्ड विद ब्रूइंग कॉफी एंड ही डिड नॉट पे अटेंशन. एबेनेसर ब्रूअर 1870. डिक्शनरी ऑफ फ्रेज एंड फेबल. विल यू रिमेंबर. यो Sanjaya has a copy of it which she never opened. Abhi to open karo. Karna hi padega. 1870 Ebenezer Brewer. The first purely English alphabetical dictionary, Dash, was written by the English school teacher Robert Cawdrey in 1604. A to Z Dictionary of English. Will they write that book in 1604? A table alphabetical or alphabetical lexicon. Which will be the title? Net hall ticket is not released, guys. Koi nahi aayega. A to Z Dictionary of English doesn't sound like 1604 title. Alphabetical lexicon doesn't sound like 1604 title. It is a table alphabetical. A purely English alphabetical dictionary. All the words in alphabetical order. It was made by a school teacher. It is called a table alphabetical. Will you remember? You will remember now, Robert Caudry made it. Ta-da-dang, a table alphabetical. Actually, it has two L's. Two L's. Who was the editor of a dictionary of slang and unconventional English? 1937. A dictionary of slang and unconventional English. Yes. Mujhe lag raha hai, thoda postponed ho jayega shayad. Few days it will be postponed, but fikar mat karo, aap padhte raho, ho jayega na. Unnecessarily tension, kyun le rahe ho? Jab hona hai, hone do, tab tak hum theek se padhenge. That's all. If you get a few more days, it's good na. IVB will do a WB set also. Editor of Dictionary of Slang and Unconventional English is definitely Eric Partridge. Eric Partridge. YouTubers, Eric Partridge, they are all writing correctly. Zoomers are also writing. Array, who created English synonyms explained in 1818? Kahi dekha hai itna sara questions on dictionaries. Who created English synonyms explained? Ayyo, it is easy. George Crab, George Lobster, George Oyster, George Shrimp, George Fish. Nahi to, ek ka spelling to alag hai. Priya Sharma, no offline class right now. Ek ka spelling alag hai, to pakda gaya. Ek to pakda gaya. English synonyms explained is a thesaurus. It is not dictionary, it is a thesaurus. English synonyms explained. It is by George Crabb. George Crabb wrote English Synonyms Explained. Will you remember? Lobster, oyster, maine banaya options to help you remember. English, George Crabb, like that you remember. I'm giving you code to remember. George Crabb wrote English Synonyms Explained. Theek hai, next. Nice collection of questions. Now appreciate me. I took from different literary terms books and thoda sa Google search bhi kar diya. Maine. You will study now, right? But I want more and more appreciation. Nah, this is not enough now. Nah. Thank you. Zoomers appreciated. Now YouTubers, you can also do. Meanwhile, when was Rogers' Thesaurus first published? Is it 1752, 1852, 1952? Rogers' Thesaurus. Thank you, guys. I will not only make the questions, I will give you PDF also. When was Rogers' Thesaurus first published? Bolo. Thank you. 1755, 1855, 1955. Kya hai? Thesaurus means so. After dictionaries only thesaurus was made. It can't be 1752 because it's so early. It must be 1852. Rogers Thesaurus, 1852. Chronological arrangement, they will ask. Okay. Chronological arrangement also, they will ask. 1852. When was the first edition of Encyclopedia Britannica published in 3 volumes? I said this in an Academy special class. An Academy special class. Those who trust me and my method, you should join an Academy for that, using that option, using that 12 plus 2 offer. I'm telling you, it is really economical. If you do not mind spending that money, you should definitely spend it. Because I am, my vada, I am telling you, it will be really good for you. 1 year fully listening to these audios, videos, using PowerPoint, it will be amazing. First edition of Encyclopedia Britannica, Zoomers all said it. It is 1771, that is right. 1771. Then, with which of these was Colin McFarquhar and Andrew Bell associated? Colin McFarquhar and Andrew Bell were associated with what? Is it World Book Encyclopedia, Encyclopedia Britannica, Encyclopedia Mythica? Suno. एनसाइक्लोपीडिया ब्रिटानिका के बारे में बोलने से पहले मैं क्या वर्ल्ड बुक एनसाइक्लोपीडिया के बारे में बोलूंगी क्या? नहीं ना. एनसाइक्लोपीडिया ब्रिटानिका. एनसाइक्लोपीडिया ब्रिटानिका वॉज कंसीव्ड, इट वॉज द आइडिया ऑफ कॉलिन मैकफार्कुहार. कॉलिन मैकफार्कुहार एंड एंड्रू बेल स्टार्टेड द वर्क ऑन एनसाइक्लोपीडिया ब्रिटानिका. विल यू रिमेंबर? Yo, that was a wonderful work that they did, isn't it? And give me 1 second. I want to show you this. The wonderful work that An Academy did is 12 plus 2 offer. Up to 30th September, I know you know. I'm simply reminding you. 12 plus 2 offer means for 1 year, if you take An Academy subscription, you will be able to watch the videos again, 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 get all the MCQs and every PDF, and you will really have thorough basic knowledge. And you will be paying only like 1,000 per month. You should use my referral code Kalyani Valla, that's one word, and you can then do this complete course. Isn't that amazing? Complete course. Then you can do this MCQ course, which is now going. Even when the course is over, you can still listen to the videos and audios. So please join, subscribe using this offer before 30th September if you want to invest on your career. Okay, next. So Colin Farquhar and Andrew Bell, Encyclopedia Britannica, wonderful. That work they did, remember, okay? Next, when was Chambers' Dictionary first published? 1672, 1772, 1872. Galat mat karna. It is obvious. Chambers' Dictionary. Bolo, when was it published? Obviously, it can't be 1672. It can't be 1772. It is 1872. Please don't draw on the screen. It is 1872. Chambers Dictionary, first published in 1872. Will you remember, guys? I hope you will remember. 1872. Remember the years once again, okay? 1852 was what, guys? 1852. Ta-dang! Rogers' Thesaurus. 1852. Will you make a note of the years once again and study? Promise me you will. 1852, Rogers' Thesaurus. 1872, Chambers' Dictionary. Clear? Next. Who of the following edited the Encyclopedia, which upheld the ideals of the Enlightenment? Encyclopedia was in French. French. So who made Encyclopedia, which upheld the ideals of the Enlightenment? It is Denis Diderot. Denis Diderot wrote Encyclopedia. And many of the contributors had to go into hiding. Government was going to arrest them. Encyclopedia, for writing Encyclopedia. Will you remember, guys? It It was a very major book of the Enlightenment. Denis Diderot. Ta-da-dang! The earliest of English encyclopedias, Lexicon Technicum, and Universal English Dictionary of Arts and Sciences, 1704, was made by... It was one of the earliest of English encyclopedias called Lexicon Technicum, a Universal English Dictionary of Arts and Sciences subtitle. 1704, array, so early. Encyclopedia, who made it? Actually, the name is a simple name. A Lexicon Technicum title is so difficult, but the name of the author is simple. But then I sat and found difficult options. The title of the encyclopedia is difficult, but actually the name of the man is simple. John Harris. Now, will you remember? Earliest English encyclopedia has a difficult title, Lexicon Technicum and Universal English Dictionary of Arts and Sciences. So difficult. But actually, name of the man is simple, John Harris. TK, remember, will you? 1704. Ta-da-dang! Cyclopedia and Universal Dictionary of Arts and Sciences. 1728 was made by Dash, known as the father of modern encyclopedia. John Harris was not called father because he didn't make it properly. John Harris was not made father. So our father made an encyclopedia and copied the title. Title is copy. C nahi hai. It is B only. Ephraim Chambers. You thought it's because Chambers is dictionary, na? Remember, Chambers is dictionary and also encyclopedia. Chambers is dictionary and also encyclopedia. Remember? Ye to father hai encyclopedia ka, lekin chura liya title. Cyclopedia and Universal Dictionary of Arts and Sciences is a copy of John Harris's and Universal English Dictionary of Arts and Sciences. Will you remember? Father is Ephraim Chambers. Father of encyclopedia. Will you remember? Ta-da-dang! Which of these is true? Abhi to aap log jaan gaye honge ki. Are pehle to padho. All nahi hoga. Padho theek se. Theek se padho. Please don't draw on the screen. The Edinburgh Encyclopedia is in 18 volumes. Printed and published by William Blackwood. Edited by David Brewster. Oh. Yes, sab sahi hoga kya? 1808 and 1830 published. All bol rahe ho. Pehle padho na. The Edinburgh Encyclopedia, 18 volumes, published by William Blackwood, edited by David Brewster. You should read everything, think, and then say all. That is like a scholar. Encyclopedia Americana came in 1829 to 33. It's a general encyclopedia written in American English and was the first major multi-volume encyclopedia of the United States. The Dictionary of National Biography, very famous, is an encyclopedia on notable figures from British history, published since 1885. Now, YouTubers and Zoomers, what will you do? You will read everything like this. You should sit and think like this and then say, yeah, all are true. Please say all are true. Are. Kya hua? I forgot to change the slides. I forgot to put the answer. Koi nahi, abhi to kar sakti hoon. All are true. All are true. Ting ting, ting ting. Ting ting, ting ting. Tang tang. Everything okay? Got it right? All are true. Who made the Shakespeare glossary in 1911? This is confusing. This is really confusing. You are dying to say Sir George Grove, I know. You are dying to say Sir George Grove, I know, but galat hoga. Galat hoga. Shakespeare glossary kisne likha? Ta-da-dang, are ro ro ke etymology binaya aur fir baith ke Shakespeare glossary bhi binaya. Pehle to Shakespeare glossary binaya, fir baad mein 66 mein binaya etymology. Ye onions chodega nahi hamara piche. Onions Shakespeare glossary banaya aur English wo historical principles English wala banaya aur uske baad etymology dictionary banaya. Onion, you know, bahut fayda hai ghar mein hone se. Bahut kuch bana sakte hai uske saath. Onions has so many uses. Onions makes English wala historical principles dictionary. Onions ne banaya etymology dictionary or Shakespeare glossary. Onions ke bare mein hame likhna chahiye ek encyclopedia. Deepak Maurya is making one expressing one desire. Kaash sari dictionary yahi bana leta to kitna aasan ho jata. If all dictionaries he made, it would have been so easy. CT onions. That is the end of today's dictionary discussion. Did you like it? Remember onions. I am dedicating this video to CT onions. Thank you very much. Maine bahut kuch galti kiya aaj. I didn't make slide properly. I didn't know onions did not write American. Lekin I am sure, because I am teaching you with sincerity, I am sure it will only help you. My mistakes also will only help you. I have so much prayer that some of these questions will come in your exam. और आप लोग अनियन से पकोड़ा बनाएंगे एग्जाम में. अनियन मैं देती हूं आपको अनियन, आप उसका इस्तेमाल करो और पकोड़ा बना लो. आई थिंक आई एम गोइंग क्रेजी ऑल्सो. नॉट ओनली आई एम टायर्ड, अयो आई एम गोइंग क्रेजी ऑल्सो. I hope exam won't be postponed. Nahi to main so nahi paungi, naha nahi paungi, kuch kha nahi paungi aur pagal bhi ho jaungi. Theek hai, so thank you, good night, happy pakoda time, take all the onions and use them well. Bye bye, all pakodas dedicated to CT onions and my lovely students. Bye bye. Good night. Thank you for loving my PPT. Please like the video.